Hello students, in this video I will teach you chapter number 10 from English reader Beehive. The name of the chapter is Kathmandu. I will summarize the chapter to you and after that you know that you will have to read the chapter line by line. Further, in case you guys have doubts, you can clear it out from me. Vikram Seth describes his visit to the capital of Nepal, Kathmandu, from his book Heaven Lake. So in this chapter, the writer Vikram Seth will describe about his experience in Nepal, Kathmandu. During his trip, he visits two temples where he notices stark differences between them. So during the trip, the writer visits two temples and there were major differences between them. They were actually quite different from each other. One temple was a pilgrimage for Hindus, the Pashupatinath temple. So the first temple was Pashupatinath temple and it was only for Hindus. After that, there was the Bodhnath temple, which is for the Buddhists. He notices that they restricted the entry of the Pashupatinath temple to only Hindus. So the name of the second temple was Bodhnath temple and it was for Buddhists. And the writer had noticed that in case of Pashupatinath temple, only Hindus were supposed to enter that place. Thus, there was quite a chaos amongst the tourist priests and the pilgrims. So because only Hindus were allowed, there was a lot of mess and confusion between the tourists and the priests and also the pilgrims. Pilgrims, the ones who pray. To top it all, people were polluting the river Bagmati by washing clothes in it, bathing in it and throwing away dry flowers in it. There was a river named Bagmati and people were actually polluting it by washing clothes, by taking a bath in it and also throwing away drying flowers. After that, he went to the Bodhnath temple, which was for the Buddhists. He saw that the scenario here was completely different from what he saw at the Pashupatinath temple. This Buddhist temple had a huge dome which is white in color. So, there was a huge difference between Bodhnath and Pashupatinath temples. In the Buddhist temple, the Bodhnath temple, there was a huge dome which was of white color. The place was very calm and serene. Outside the temple, there was a Tibetan market and people were selling bags, clothes, ornaments and more. So in Pashupatinath temple, because of the chaos that only the Hindus are going to enter, there was a lot of confusion and there was no peace. But in Bodhnath temple, there was calmness and there was peace everywhere. Outside the temple, there was a market where people were selling different things like bags, clothes, jewelry and more. He notices the numerous things Kathmandu offers from religious places to many tourist destinations. So these were things that was provided by Kathmandu from the religious places at the tourist destinations so that people who come from outside, they can buy them. Moreover, it also has various shops of antiques, cameras, cosmetics, chocolates and more. So there were more shops of antique things, unique items, cameras, cosmetics is makeup items, chocolates and even more. Nonetheless, it is also a very noisy city from the car honks to the music and vendors. So Kathmandu is very noisy city because of the car horns and the music and also the vendors. Vendors are people who sell stuff on the roads, on the streets. He enjoyed having the marzipan bar, corn, Coca-Cola in the city. So these were the three things he had eaten, marzipan bar, corn and Coca-Cola. After that, he also read love stories, comics and Reader's Digest books. He had read all these things. On returning to Delhi, he thought of taking an adventurous route which comprises of a bus or train journey and then a boat ride, but he dropped the idea for that would have been too tiring. So while he was returning to Delhi, he had thought that he could have an adventurous route where first he is going to take a bus or a train and after that he is going to take a boat for the ride, but he had dropped the plan, which means he had cancelled that plan because he thought that he will become really tired after it. Thus, he booked a flight ticket. So he had again thought that he is going to fly back to Delhi. He saw an interesting flute seller outside his hotel. He had a pole with a lot of flutes on it and seemed like a porcupine body. So outside the hotel of the writer, there was a flute seller and he had a long pole with him and a lot of flutes were hanging over there and his body was like a porcupine. Porcupine is sort of an animal. You can just go and Google it, you'll understand. The flute seller kept playing his flutes and also did so in many different tunes. So outside his hotel, there was a flute seller and he was playing the flute in different tunes. But what set him apart from the other flute sellers was that he played the flute thoughtfully. He did not scream to attract customers he played. But this flute seller was different from the other sellers. Why? Because the other sellers were shouting and attracting people. But this flute seller was actually just playing the flute and people were automatically attracted towards him. He did not shout and ask the customers to buy it from him. This attracted the author and he wondered that the flute is so common all over. So the author was attracted that this particular seller was actually playing the flute and not shouting and asking everybody to buy it. And also he was wondering that flute is a very common equipment in Kathmandu. Then he compares it to the human voice and says how he is noticing even the little things now. Further, he had started comparing the flute and the human voice, and then he thought to himself that he is actually noticing the details. So here the chapter ends. This was his experience in Kathmandu and everything has been explained. Please read the chapter again so that you understand. In case there is anything you fail to understand, you can ask me. I'll clear your doubt. That's it for the video and the chapter. The summary has been explained. Thank you so much for your patience, all of you.